everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Hearts of Iron 4. But it's not any of the current series. This time, as you can tell by the title, we're doing something different, okay? So we're doing 100% vanilla Iron Man, and we're just going to do a simple achievement run for an achievement that I haven't got because I suck as Germany, and I think I found a new technique that works for me. Yay! But basically, I've run out of ideas for content at the moment. I'm going to be honest, I'm waiting on the release of the Cold War mod to come back out just so I have some flavor to work with. And I'm really, really wanting to get a few ideas, but just so I can work on that idea without the stress of worrying, oh no, series are coming to an end, This is going to be like a filler series. This is going to be like a filler content. So there's still content. You guys can still enjoy it. I can still have fun making stuff. But also at the same time, it gives me time to think of an idea before I run out of time. So so without further ado, welcome to the Germany run. So 1936, Gathering Storm. We go in as Uncle Addy. And just double click it. There you go. Iron Man on regular. Let's go. Bish bash boss. Let's get stuck in. Okie dokie, so let's begin. The achievement that we're actually going to be going for this time is Operation Sea Lion. Control the British mainland as Germany. Simple enough. Also, if I get a chance to, I might do Sink the Pride of the British Fleet, just because, why not? that's the plan, at least. But what I'm going to do, I'm just going to quickly start off, do a bunch of just rando research stuff. Again, it doesn't truly matter what I pick for this idea that I've got. Again, my idea is very, oh my lordy lord, no, that's the one I want. There we go. Yes. So again, we're just gonna be very, very quick about what I got so many ships to do. Hold on. Okay, so now that the ships are done, what I'm gonna do straight off the bat, I'm actually going to go for a four-year plan. Now normally people go for the army just because that way you can get stuff quicker, but I'm hoping that I'm not going to need the army innovation straight off the bat. If I have to be wholly honest with myself just here. There we go. I want every tile like this to have a mill factory being built. Fantastic. Now, what I also want to do, I want to come back up the top here. I'm actually going to go bush like that. Put that up to a 3. Put that up to a 5. Light tank priority. Put that up to a 3. And then everything else can just sort of do its own thing. That's what I'm going to be doing here. I'm actually going to be boosting as much industry as I can into the light tanks. I do feel like it's a necessity, one that we desperately need. So put everything on free speed just so I can keep everything all organized and such. And yeah, I mean, that's the general idea, the general strat that I'm going for. And it could be wrong. It could be a very bad strat, but it's a strat that I'm trying nonetheless. Oh God, no pressure. Okay, so now I finally got everything in somewhat of an order. I'm just going to quickly round up the Navy as well. That's nothing of importance. Just because I'm a bit of an OCD freak. Everything come here, please. but now everything's sort of in place. It's literally just a matter of sit back and wait. I'm also actually going to go like this. So how many do I need here? I need 18. So let's just go 18 like that real quick. Set divisions like that. Priority. Just because, again, personal preference over everything else. And now we just wait. Now I literally just wait. All I'm waiting for now is soldiers, PP, and factories. I want the PP, I want the soldiers, and I want the factories. And again, it's just going to wait. The idea is, I wait until 38, and then 38 is where all hell breaks loose, and I should have everything by 39. That is the plan, that is the strat. Again, it all comes down to practicality. Anything can happen, but fingers crossed things go our way, this time at least. Okie dokie, so now we finally got our first 150 PP, okay? So the plan is, normally I would go straight to war economy, but first we need that 50% war support. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm going, monarchist media mogul? I didn't even see that there. Okay, anyway, ignoring that. What we actually want is Joseph Goebbels. Mr. Goebbels is what I'm needing. I'm wanting fascism and I'm wanting war support. Normally I also want Mr. Hess because of that political power. But right now, to be completely truthful, Mr. Goebbels is priority numero uno, because I do need that war support and I do desperately need to get that up to 50%, because if it's up to 50%, I can go war economy, and this can speed up. Also, the reason I'm putting in civvies first when I need mills is obviously because I need to mass produce the mills as quick as possible, which is another reason why I'm going down the autarky focus, because what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go autarky, which gives the construction speed bonuses. I'm also going to go for Hermann Goering work, KDF wagon work, then leave it. I'm going to leave it completely at that point, and then that's when I'm going to come down Army Innovations. Just to speed things up, and hopefully by then, I'll also be in a place good enough with enough manpower to where I can actually say, hey, Austria, do you want to join the fun? And then Austria will be like, yeah, of course I do. It looks great. And then we can all just, you know, live happily ever after and all that fun stuff. That's the plan, at least. Okie dokie now. So things are slowly starting to come together. Those divisions are nearly finished with their production. If I could just actually select them, that would be great. There we go. So our two armies are nearly in place. These guys are nearly done. Now, once these guys are done, I still can't do war economy. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to come down here and I'm going to go silent workhorse, because that way I get more political power and we can do everything a whole lot more quicker. KDF wagons in place. We're, again, pumping out these factories like there's no one's business, which is great news. 10 days for improved machine. Again, this is good because we just need to keep focusing on the industry. Keep the industry up to date. Obviously, the more industry there is, the quicker it is, the quicker it is to build stuff, which is fantastic, because I love building stuff. Building stuff quickly is ideal. It's perfect circumstance. Get the radio in as well. It's still too early to be doing that. It's still way too early to be doing that. So what we're actually going to do now is check doctrine. Is doctrine cheaper? No. Okay, then what we're going to do, we are going to work on support companies, because again, support companies are essential. Although we're going to be using our tanks a fair bit, infantry still carries most of the weight, so we need a lot of love shown to those infantry divvies literally popping down here on Austria. So that should be the last of that. So I'm going to wait for that one to come through. And then this guy will go like this. Fantastic. Put that onto a 2 like so. Wonderful. Absolutely bloody wonderful. Fantastic. Couldn't be happier. Okie dokie. So now that our cabinet is filled up, we have got Joseph Goebbels. We have got Rudolf Hess. And we have Mr. Heinrich Himmler. We just finished all of the main civvy stuff just here. We got army innovations and now we're doing extra research slot because I do want to have my support companies at hand. But I'm also about to do something quite, how can I put it this way, quite different. I'm not going to use any political power apart from small ones on events like MIFO bills and this. I'm only going to use political power for those stuff, for those things, right? We're not going to use political power until we have a stockpile of 450. Now, that might seem absolutely crazy, and I'm going to be honest, it probably is. But I do need it to be the case, because we are going to stockpile all the factories we can right now. Political power doesn't matter anymore. We're finishing off the last of these guys just here, and we are going to start on working for... mainly for factories. Factories, factories, factories. That's what matter right now. Factories extremely matter. So we're going to finish off the research slot. Once this is done, we'll do Rhineland, Anschluss. And then I'll probably do, to be fair, reassert Eastern claims. I feel like Poland's priority numero uno right here. So that's what we're going to do. And yeah, again, there's nothing really to say. I'll see you when we actually start to make some moves. Because until then... it's research, research, and more research. Okie dokie. Now, you may have thought that saving up to 450 was a terrible idea, but let me tell you, chicken, let me tell you something. So it's not as crazy as it seems. So what I've been doing this whole time is just keeping it rolling, keeping it rolling, keeping it rolling. Then, because I did the Rhineland, I got 120 PP. Just did the Anschluss, I just got a ton of political power for that as well. And soon, when this clocks out at 50... I'm going to get 120 political power back from that. Again, it all adds up. It all adds into something. And that something is great. So these guys here are going to form a new army for me. These are the Austrian troops. And they're actually going to come under the control of Witzelben over here. And what he's going to do, he's going to form up on the border just there. Again, remember guys, it all adds up, okay? So now we've got the signals in place and everything's slowly adding up, slowly but surely. Do I need to do more stuff here? No. Okay, that's all fine. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to put this guy here on artillery. Artillery is key. Artillery helps out the infantry, and that's what we need is assistance for them. Also, since we've got our 450, what we're going to do right now is we're going to go add tank designer. Mobile tank, Henschel. That gives 15%. That gives 5% max speed. Then we're going to go Blitzkrieg Furious by Heinz. That gives him 10%, okay? That's now 15% speed boost. Now, we're going to go for Erwin Rommel. Okay, that gives division attack and defense. But, do we want that right now? No. We're going to get that in a minute. Right now, we want Von Brauswitz, which gives division speed 10%. That is now a 25% speed boost on the light tanks. So we're going to do that. Now we need just another 300 political power. And what that's going to do is do war economy to speed things up. And then down here, we'll go back to Rommel, because Rommel will add an added defense and attack to that already super, super quick tank division. It's all part of the grand plan. But anyway, guys, that's where I'm going to end today's episode. Thank you very much for watching. If you have enjoyed this, don't forget to, of course, click that like button and or subscribe. Share me with your friends to help the growth of the channel and all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the next episode. I've been Anglo. Have a good one. Ta-da.